We want to solve the given log equation. The first thing we should notice is these logarithms don't have the base given, which means these are both common logs or log base 10. To solve this log equation, we want to combine these two logarithms and then write the log equation as an exponential equation to solve for x. Notice we have a difference of two logs with the same base, so we'll be using the quotient property of logarithms given here to combine the two logs. And again, because we have a difference, we can combine them into a single log by taking the quotient of the number of parts of the logarithms. So common log of the quantity x plus 4 minus the common log of the quantity x plus 2 is equal to the common log of x plus 4 divided by x plus 2. This is still equal to 2. And of course, our base is still 10. So now we can write this as an exponential equation by recognizing that 10 is the base, 2 is the exponent, and the number is this fraction here. So as an exponential equation, we would have 10 raised to the second power must equal the quantity x plus 4 divided by the quantity x plus 2. Again, 10 to the second must equal quantity x plus 4 divided by the quantity x plus 2. Well, 10 squared is equal to 100. Now from here, we can multiply both sides of the equation by x plus 2, or we could put 100 over 1. And now that we have a proportion, we can cross multiply, meaning 100 times the quantity x plus 2 must equal 1 times the quantity x plus 4. So again, 100 times the quantity x plus 2 is equal to 1 times the quantity x plus 4, or just x plus 4. Again, we get the same thing if we multiplied both sides of the equation by the quantity x plus 2. Now we'll distribute and solve for x. So we have 100x plus 200 equals x plus 4. Let's go ahead and continue this over here on the right. If we want to solve for x, we need x on one side of the equation. So let's go ahead and subtract x on both sides. So we have 99x plus 200 equals 4. Subtract 200 on both sides. So we have 99x equals, this will be negative 196. Last step, divide both sides by 99. So we have x equals negative 196 divided by 99. We should try to simplify this, but it doesn't simplify. But we also need to check to see if this is a possible value for x. What I mean by that is, going back up to the original equation, we know the number part of the logarithms have to be greater than 0. So looking at the second log here, notice how x has to be greater than negative 2. So if this value is not greater than negative 2, there's no solution to this log equation. Well, we should recognize that this fraction is larger than negative 2, but just to be sure, if we wanted to, we can convert it to a decimal. Let's go ahead and do that to double check. Negative 196 divided by 99. And notice how this decimal would be to the right of negative 2 on the number line, and therefore it is greater than negative 2 and our solution. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.